Hi guys, my name is Crystal, and this is a first, but I'm going to be recording a reaction to the Nintendo Direct. Yes, this is pretty new for me, so forgive me if everything's pretty awkward. But before it starts, I really hope, especially after how successful Miitopia was, I really, really am hoping for a Tomodachi Life with all the same customizations as Miitopia, because it was so good. Also, we've been waiting for Metroid for some time as well. Oh, my alarm. Sorry about that, that was my alarm for my medication. This recording is going great to begin with. But it should be starting soon. So let's see. I don't know if I have to refresh. Let's see if I have to refresh or not. Usually it just kind of starts. No, it says it's live. But yes, welcome to this video. This is my first time. Oh yes, it's beginning, it's starting. I hope the audio is not too loud. Yes, COVID-19 has affected a lot of game companies. Let's turn down this. Hopefully it's not too loud.
Hello everyone. I'm Shinya Takahashi, and I'll be your guide for today's Nintendo Direct.
Hello, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll be your guide as well.
I wonder how long this Direct's going to be.
The Nintendo Switch system is now in its fifth year, and many people around the world are playing games on it.
5 years for the Nintendo Switch already? That's crazy. Felt like it just came out.
Spanning all ages and all levels of gaming experience. Thank you all very much. We've been able to offer a wide variety of games on the system, not just from Nintendo, but also from our many development and publishing partners.
Like Sega?
I hope that each of you watching this Nintendo Direct will be able to find a game that suits your personal tastes.
Oh my goodness.
Today, we have news on upcoming Nintendo Switch games, and we'll be focusing on a selection of games releasing this year. We hope you enjoy it.
Guys,
to begin, please take a look at this video.
Oh my gosh, what could it be? What's the first thing they're gonna show? Ooh, two snaps. Oh! Ganon? What could this be? This is a Breath of the Wild too, is it?
Get ready for the next battle.
Oh! This is I'm sitting here thinking, what's the heck in the Zelda game? Uh-oh.
What
happened? They're having some trouble, I guess, with the, Interesting. Honestly, wasn't expecting this. Throwing everyone off the cliff. Oh my god. What is happening? Oh my goodness. He's just throwing everyone off the cliff. I don't know why that's so funny to me. He's taking everyone's stocks.
Oh
Nice, right off the back with some Smash Bros. News. That's pretty good. No! Don't do it, you monster! How could he? What a monster. Oh, okay, Kirby's good.
Hello, I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited, and the director of the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game.
This poor man is trying his best.
Game series Tekken will join the battle. Surprise! I'll go over the details at a later date, so please sit tight. For today, though, we've prepared a short video to showcase Kazuya's moves in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please take a look.
All right. Let's see who's satisfied and who's not. It is the Smash community after all. Tombstone Crusher. Oh, some of these names. Nintendo. Nice. I wonder why they chose Ganon as the first person to throw off the cliff. Maybe it's to get the same reaction I had, where I thought it was a Legend of Zelda game.
I'll talk about the fighter more in a future presentation.
He looks very proud of this one, doesn't he?
First, actually. The air date is shown below. Please stay tuned.
Thank you, Mr. Sakurai. New fighter Kazuya will join the fight in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please look forward to seeing how Kazuya, who has experienced many harsh battles across the Tekken series, will fight in this game. All right. Let's continue with our first batch of Nintendo Switch headlines.
What's next?
Your choices matter in these emotional supernatural tales.
Looks pretty. Okay. It looks gorgeous, doesn't it? Wow.
Life is Strange: True Colors launches on Nintendo Switch September 10th. And Life is Strange Remastered Collection.
I never got to watch the game before, or play it actually.
There's something for everyone on the Nintendo Switch system. You are Star-Lord, leading a legendary band of heroes for hire in this thrilling action-adventure game. Jump on a wild ride across the cosmos, overwhelm opponents with Star-Lord's daring combat style, and encounter iconic and original Marvel characters. You'll call the shots for the unpredictable Guardians as you face cosmic threats to save the galaxy. You got this, probably. Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy blasts onto Nintendo Switch October 26th. Worms everywhere!
What is this?
In this real-time arena-based shooter, you'll squish your invertebrae opponents in 32-player cross-platform combat.
32-player? Oh my god, I guess that could be fun.
Your way up the ranks. Plus, the Patchwork Bear outfit, exclusive to the Nintendo Switch version, will be available for free for 2 weeks after launch. A new map, Spaceport Showdown, launches with Worms Rumble wriggling onto Nintendo Switch June 23rd. Get a 25% discount when you pre-order the game starting today on Nintendo eShop.
32 players, huh?
The fantastical realm of Orcanon awaits. As you explore this fully hand-painted world, you'll customize a team of demigods and unleash devastating attacks and captivating turn-based combat. Astria Ascending launches on Nintendo Switch September 30th. Return to the funny, charming, and quirky world of Two Point County. In the wholesome management sim Two Point Campus, you'll build and run
isn't
your
this,
very own university.
Isn't this kind of based off that when we had the Sonic Central where the Sonic characters are in the hospital? Isn't that the same game?
Starts on Nintendo Switch next year. A beloved series rolls into its 20th anniversary, this year.
Nice! Wow, I haven't seen him in a long time. Of course, besides like Sonic Racing games or Sega Racing. I never got to play one though. This may be my chance.
When Super Monkey Ball Banana Mania rolls onto Nintendo Switch October 5th. It's a blast from parties past.
And you're invited.
Ready for another round of Mario Party Mayhem?
Yeah!
Of course you are! It's a
time to lose friends!
And mini games. Live it up on 5 classic boards from the Nintendo 64 era, including Peach's Birthday Cake and Space Land.
Ooh.
Each board is packed with zany events guaranteed to keep you on your toes. And when we say zany, we mean it. Jump. Connect blocks. Give facelifts? In hilarious over-the-top minigames. All of which support button controls. With 100 minigames from the Mario Party series catalog, you'll have a blast in this all-star fun fest. Here's a little party favor. All game modes work with online play.
Nice.
Even if you're partying solo, you can randomly match with other partygoers worldwide. Playing a board game online with
so
friends.
So even after my friends have moved, I can still hang out and play with them. That's pretty nice.
Then resume the festivities. Stickers are also available to communicate with others. It's time to
stickers like in Pokemon Go.
Party Superstars, launching on the Nintendo Switch system October 29th.
Nice.
Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
What did you think? Before we show this next trailer, I'd like to say one thing. Currently, we're working hard on the latest game in the Metroid Prime series, Metroid Prime 4, which we previously announced. But today, we'd like to introduce another new entry in the Metroid franchise.
Wow!
Let's take a look.
Nice! My sister's gonna be so happy. Metroid 5! You can't put Metroid 5 out without putting 4 out yet, what? Looks amazing. Oh wow, it's like it has the original, like, 64 view. That's pretty cool. Wow. That's awesome. Look at that. Wow. It's like you're playing on a 64. That's pretty cool. 64. Do you hear me? I'm so dumb. The Super Nintendo. That's pretty cool. Oh my goodness. This looks so cool. It looks so good. It's like if the Super Nintendo version and Metroid Prime like had a baby. Metroid Dread. Nice. Okay, Nintendo Treehouse. Okay. That's so soon.
That was the trailer for the first new 2D Metroid game in roughly 19 years. The brand new Metroid Dread game.
I'm gonna have to message let her know that another one's coming out so soon. She's been waiting.
Showcasing a variety of
my sister
that
or
Samus
you know.
Will encounter. It's scheduled to be released on October 8th, so it won't be too long until launch.
I know a gift I have to buy.
We'll also be releasing Amiibo figures for Samus and the Emmy.
I know two gifts I have to buy.
Let's move on to more Nintendo Switch headlines.
What's next? So good so far.
These familiar franchises are back on Nintendo Switch.
What?
Get ready to get down in the latest Just Dance game. Hit the dance floor in Just Dance 2022.
Time to lose some weight, y'all.
The arcade smash hit Cruisin' Blast is speeding onto Nintendo Switch. Blast your way through nearly 30 over-the-top tracks.
Oh, is that a unicorn? Or a Pegasus?
Four players can race together, so pick your favorite vehicle and hit the road.
Nice. This kind of reminds me of V-Rally. V-Rally? Was that? I forgot. I think that's what it was called.
It's the ultimate Dragon Ball Z.
I'm gonna get hate for this, but I'm about tired of seeing Dragon Ball Z.
Relive the story of Goku and other
My brother's obsessed with Dragon Ball Z. It's all I see. RPG. Not to mention, I went back to go watch Dragon Ball Z after like not watching it for a while, and like I wasn't very happy. I definitely thought it was way better of a series back when I watched it when I was younger, but when I went back to watch it, it's kind of not that amazing. The story is not that good. I'm gonna get a lot of hate for that. I'm sorry.
Collecting ingredients for delicious meals. You could always train to acquire new skills too.
But the Frieza and Cell Saga and even the Majin Buu Saga are still pretty good. But
one and two is also included.
Goku is I don't like him as a character.
Nintendo Switch September 24th. Grab a golf club and get ready to tee off.
I'm gonna get canceled for not liking Dragon Ball Z.
The Mario Golf Super Rush game launches soon. Here's a quick glimpse into each of the modes. Standard golf.
Only Nintendo can make golf fun.
Wind and terrain on the greens.
Nice shot.
Hit different types of shots and aim for under par.
Nice birdie.
Speed golf.
Aw, look at Bowser.
Be the first to get your ball.
He's got little shoes. Well,
outpace your
big shoes. Bowser's my favorite. Pauline's in there too.
Battle golf. Duke it out over 9 flag marked holes in an
Oh my god, Bowser's wearing pants and shoes.
Golf adventure. Go from rookie to pro with your Mii
Please,
character.
More Mii's. Please, more Mii's. Bring me Tomodachi life.
And here's some news. Free updates are planned for future release, including additional courses and playable characters. The fairway's almost open, so set your tee time and get ready to ace those shots in Mario Golf Super Rush, swinging onto the Nintendo Switch system June 25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop. Ready for the ride of a lifetime? Welcome to the vast and vibrant world of Monster Hunter.
Monster Hunter? Didn't we just have a Monster Hunter game drop?
As a rider in this RPG adventure, you'll explore diverse landscapes by riding your Monstie, a monster companion. Gather materials such as honey and ore, then use them to craft items for your journey.
Excuse me.
But beware of the many monsters roaming about. Some are docile, but others may suddenly ambush you.
But this kind of gives me hope, because I was worried they weren't going to drop any Tomodachi news, because they just dropped Miitopia news. But if they just dropped some Monster Hunter news and then they just dropped this, there could be a good chance. Not to kind of over, you know, shine Monster Hunter. Monster Hunter is good, but it gives me hope for Tomodachi life.
Join up with friends for co-op multiplayer quests and battles. Buckle up, Ryder. It's going to be a real monster of an adventure. Monster Hunter Stories 2 Wings of Ruin soars onto Nintendo Switch July 9th. You can play the free demo on June 25th and carry over your save data to the full game.
Nice.
Here's a new game from the head.
Gee, I wonder who that is.
Did you miss me? Hey, what do you mean? Who am I? It's-a me, Wario! And it's a finally ready, a brand new game from my company! Check it out! You get to control me! Time to do this!
These games are always so weird, but they're fun!
What rats!
Are those birds pooping?
They came back, and they have wonderful new talents! Throw that stick thing. Not the bad. Use the spinny, whatchamacallit. Ha! Nailed it! Same micro game, different abilities. Wah! I almost forgot some big news. Two people can play together at the same time. So play nice, or else.
I've got to tell Cecile and Izzy, I'm sure they'll be happy.
Yes, you.
Multiplayer games are always fun.
Ready for some micro game mayhem.
The WarioWare Get It Together game launches exclusively on the Nintendo Switch.
So many games are coming out in September, huh?
Today on Nintendo eShop.
What you just saw was the trailer for WarioWare Get It Together.
WarioWare.
In the latest installment of this series, there are new microgames that let you control Wario and his friends. There is also a two-player co-op mode, which greatly expands the gameplay.
I'm excited about the co-op
future, so stay tuned.
Me and Goliath can play.
Next, please take a look at this.
What's next? Please.
As a high school student living in Tokyo, your life is fairly normal.
For a minute, it looked familiar.
But that reality is upended after you get pulled into a different dimension.
Different dimension? That's not new.
Another Tokyo exists, a post-apocalyptic world where angels and demons reside. Suddenly, you fuse with a mysterious figure, gaining the power to fight demons. What lies ahead in this alternate realm?
It looks like it could be fun, though.
Sprawling, demon-infested wasteland.
Is this one co-op?
Friendly demons do exist here, Many are hostile and will attempt to destroy you. Harness your newfound powers to fight demons using a command-based system. Finding their weak point is key. By targeting it, the number of consecutive actions you can perform
sorry for the,
will increase.
Excessive yawning. My medicine makes me really tired.
Are
I started some new medication and it makes me sleepy, and one of the side effects is actually excessive yawning, and I'm sorry.
Conversation with them.
This music is good.
If the negotiation is successful, a demon will become a powerful ally. In some
what
cases,
is that?
By rejecting a demon's request, they may feel motivated and join you as an ally.
Interesting.
Demons that do join will fight alongside you and grow stronger. By abusing demon allies, another demon can be created.
Wow, we're just collecting demons and fusing
the
them now.
The demon's innate abilities will vary, granting you a powerful ally, customized to your needs and playstyle.
Some of these demons look like they belong in Digimon or Pokemon.
Challenge the many demons roaming this post-apocalyptic world by harnessing the power of your own. What destiny will
excuse me.
Shin Megami Tensei 5 will launch exclusively on Nintendo
yeah,
Switch.
Yeah, I thought I've heard of this game before.
Pre-orders for the physical version begin June 21st.
That was the latest trailer for Shin Megami Tensei 5 from Atlus. This is the newest game in the series. Please look forward to future updates. Let's see a few more Nintendo Switch headlines.
What's up next?
Celebrate 10 years of Danganronpa in despair.
I know a lot of people are going to be happy about this.
Testing. Mic check 1, 2. This is a test of the school broadcast system.
Danganronpa. 3 games in the deadly Danganronpa series are coming to Nintendo Switch.
They're porting a lot. Please port, like, some Pokemon games, too.
Onokuma, self-proclaimed school headmaster, has trapped you and other high school students in a game of literal life and death. Unfortunately, the only way out of the school and this lethal game is to betray the other students. And so it begins.
A body has been discovered!
When a student meets their demise, a class trial will take place to reveal the culprit.
You're the culprit, aren't you, Mew?
Tanya, I had no idea!
They probably moved the body there!
Use the evidence you've gathered to refute contradictions and find the guilty party.
Sneak attack!
No, it's wrong!
Are you okay?
Plus, the board game from Danganronpa V3 Killing Harmony has been expanded into a standalone game. Danganronpa S Ultimate Summer Camp. An all-star cast of characters from the Danganronpa series will come together to battle at a tropical resort. Who's the strongest of them all in this ultimate beach brawl?
Every anime needs a beach episode.
Exclusive on Nintendo Switch later this year. All 4 games will also be individually available on Nintendo eShop.
Wow.
We hope you're not afraid of ghosts.
Ghosts. Ooh, spooky.
In this horror adventure game, you'll uncover the mysteries surrounding the ethereal but deadly Mount Hikami, believed to be at the center of many disappearances. Ghosts frequent this mountain. Your only defense is a camera that can repel and cast them out.
Oh!
Face your fears as you explore a variety of unsettling locations.
Is this a port or is this new? Because I'm pretty sure this was a game at some point.
Features various protagonists, letting you experience the
pretty sure
from
I've seen
perspectives.
It.
New costumes and photo modes are included in this version. Can you investigate Mount
okay,
Hikami?
So yes, it's
alive.
Fatal
Frame, Maiden of Black Water, creeps onto Nintendo Switch this year.
Nice.
These games and DLC are coming soon. Some even today. Your war is not over.
Doom!
In the first campaign expansion for Doom Eternal, The Ancient Gods Part 1. Deeper and more challenging combat awaits.
Nice!
As you eliminate hell's
Doom is really cool.
In demon-infested ruins and rain-swept terrain. The fate of the cosmos is in your hands. Get slaying when this campaign expansion launches on Nintendo Switch later today. Get ramped up for two iconic skateboarding games.
Tony Hawk. Haven't heard that in a minute.
Defining jams as the legendary Tony Hawk and a roster of new and returning pros. Take your sessions
wow.
on all the original game modes.
I felt like I haven't heard that name in so long.
Drop into Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2, launching on Nintendo Switch.
That's
June
funny.
25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop. After 4,000 years, Sateki, the Witch Queen, has risen from the dead, and only one group of heroes can stop her. The Strange Brigade. In this thrilling adventure, you'll blast through an army of mummified monstrosities while solving puzzles in booby-trapped dungeons. Go it alone or team up with other daring adventurers in local wireless co-op and online play.
Expect co-op always makes things better.
Strange Brigade launches on Nintendo Switch
later today. At least, I think so.
It's a new adventure of cosmic proportions. Mario and his friends will team up with
gosh.
The rabbits once again to restore order to the galaxy. Our heroes must stop a mysterious new evil from plunging the universe into chaos.
I wonder how Rabbit Mario Rosalina feels about them. His...
Wait, is she bored already?
About his...
Explore
his...
With these...
These... <and even quirkier secrets. laughs> being dressed up as practically his girlfriend.
And in his fresh take on the tactical genre... Our heroes can run freely around the battlefield, creating new strategic and chaotic possibilities. So aim for victory with a little help from your friends.
Wait, who's that?
I wonder why they decided to go with this kind of collab when they first did.
Galactic adventure. Mario plus
rabbits are so weird.
Launches into space or onto Nintendo Switch next year.
Next year. I don't think I've heard of this before.
Thrilling stories, memorable characters, and vibrant gameplay are in store as you lead the commanding officers to victory. The first two Advance Wars campaigns in Advance Wars 1 Plus 2 Reboot Camp. Marching on to Nintendo Switch this holiday. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
How is everything? All right. This next segment will be our last announcement of the day.
The last one. Let's see what it is.
Take a look.
Please. Should have known it was going to be a Legend of Zelda. That's typically some pretty big news for them. So much destruction.
Hello there. I'm Eiji Aonuma, producer of the Legend of Zelda series.
This man is doing a fine job with the Legend of Zelda series.
DLC for the Hyrule Warriors.
Hasn't let us down.
The expansion pass from Koei Tecmo Games. It will follow Link and his allies through more battles that took place 100 years prior to the events of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.
Excuse me.
I hope you'll look forward to it. I have a few more things to share with you all today. We'll begin with The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD game, which launches next month.
I'll probably finally be able to beat it. I got so close to beating it, but then I started college, and then I went back to play it, and my motion control just bleh, died.
This game depicts the oldest era.
Not to mention, I got stuck in the dungeon because I went away to college and I couldn't remember what the heck I was doing.
What is the origin of the Master Sword? Why did a woman named Zelda become the legend for future generations? These will all be unraveled in this game. We hope you're looking forward.
I'll get a second chance, you guys.
Skyward Sword HD. Next up.
What's that?
Here's a little something you might like. This is a Game & Watch system that lets you play three games in the Legend of Zelda series. This year, the original Legend of Zelda game reaches its 35th anniversary. While we don't have any campaigns or other Nintendo Switch games planned, we've been working on this Game & Watch system as a special item to help mark the occasion and reflect fondly on the earliest days of The Legend of Zelda. It will come with the first game in the series, The Legend of Zelda, Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link.
That's pretty cool.
And the Game Boy version of The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening game, as well as a special version of the Game & Watch title Vermin, starring Link as the playable character. So that's four games on one system, from longer Legend of Zelda games to the pick-up-and-play game Vermin. In addition, regarding the watch functionality for the Game & Watch system, we've added a playable clock based on The Legend of Zelda, and an interactive timer themed after Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link. You can play with both of them by taking control of Link. We hope you'll enjoy playing this Game & Watch system whenever and wherever
you guys.
All right, here's the last thing we have to show you. This is the sequel to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. 2 years have passed since we first announced this game, and we've been unable to share anything with you in that time.
Here we go, guys, here we go.
Development has been steadily progressing. For today, we've prepared some new footage to show a bit more of the game. Please take a look.
It'll be beautiful as always, you guys. Legend of Zelda games progressively just get beautiful. Doesn't that look 2022? That's actually not that far, honestly.
So, what did you think? This time around,
amazing.
The setting for the adventure has been expanded to include the skies above Hyrule. We'd like to ask you to wait a bit longer.
Of course.
We're aiming for a 2022 release, so I hope you'll look forward to it.
Take your time. Your games are always so beautiful.
How was that?
Don't you guys think?
That's all for this Nintendo Direct. We are diligently continuing development on a number of other games we didn't show today. I hope you'll continue looking
forward to what's in store on Nintendo Switch. Let's hope one of those games is
Tomodachi Life. Thank you for watching.
Thank you. So, what did you guys think? Satisfied? I think the Metroid news was enough to bring some hype, because we've been waiting for such a long time since they've announced it.
Hi, everyone. Oh. I'm Doug Bowser from Nintendo of America, and I'm here with Nate Bildorf, who leads our Treehouse team. As you know, at Nintendo, we're all about creating experiences that deliver surprises and smiles. And I have to say, I found myself smiling through that entire presentation, thinking about how many unique games we'll be able to share with everyone in the weeks and months ahead. Nate, that last clip was incredible. So many questions. Where do we start? What did you think?
Oh, well, Doug, they had me at the first mysterious red tendril. You know what a massive Zelda fan I am. But that's 2022, yeah. And I'm frankly just looking forward to seeing all the games that are in the pipeline just over the next couple months for Nintendo Switch. We've got Mario Party Superstars, WarioWare Get It Together, the expansion for Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity, The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD, Mario Golf Super Rush, Advance Wars 1+2 Reboot Camp, and of course, Metroid Dread. I am just not going to be getting
Metroid is some big news.
Well, that's okay. I think I may be in the same camp. And Mario Golf Super Rush launches in just a few weeks on June the 25th. By the way, Nate, do you know why Luigi brings two pairs of pants to the golf course with him?
Doug, are we doing the dad joke thing again?
Dad jokes. In case he gets a hole in one. But seriously, everyone, this game is just...
No!
You can play in standard golf mode, but then there's also speed golf, battle golf, the golf adventure mode, and the option to play with buttons or motion controls. And you can play with up to four people locally or online. I can say this one is definitely going to be taking up the majority of my summer gaming time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you and me both.
Sorry if you guys hear that. It's starting to thunder outside.
Today, our E3 show is just getting started. Next up,
been having a lot of storms here.
Nintendo Treehouse Live, and we'll be kicking off our first segment with a very special guest, Yoshio Sakamoto, who is the producer of Metroid Dread. And he's going to be sharing his insights on, I can't believe I'm saying this, but it's the first new 2D Metroid game in nearly two decades. I'm not going to miss it, and I know you've been looking forward to it as well.
Absolutely. I am so looking forward to this. And we do have our Treehouse team on deck for a gameplay deep dive into Metroid Dread, WarioWare Get It Together, and more games in a mix of both live and pre-recorded segments today. And I'd just like to say as we close how deeply grateful we are to everyone watching today. Thank you for sharing this time with us, and we hope you enjoy it.
Thanks again, everyone. We can't wait to hear what you think. And with that, I'll turn it over to Sakamoto-san and the Treehouse team.
It looks so good. It's been so long.
2D メトロイドの完全新作メトロイドドレッドをやっと発表できました。1986年のメトロイドから始まってメトロイド2、
スーパーメトロイド was so good. That was the first one that I got to experience.
メトロイドシリーズはサムス・アランという女性バウンティーハンターの活躍を描いたゲームです。
I remember when I first found out Samus was a girl. I was like, wait, what?
してファンのためだけのゲームではないです。基本は 2D アク
ション。 They've gotta be so happy and proud. It's been such a long time. 誰でも楽しんでもらえるはずです。
これが初めてのメトロイドという人でもゲームのプロローグを見てもらえればストーリーがわからないということにはならないです。
Sam is just confident so much. Oh my goodness.
メトロイドという人だからこその楽しみ方もあるんじゃないでしょうかね。タイトルになっているドレッドの意味は恐怖です。無敵のサムス・アランを襲う絶望的な恐怖を表すタイトルです。行ったこともない惑星で一人で行動するサムスに忍び寄る圧倒的な存在というように
This poor woman always is going through dread exploring unknown planets. Give this woman a break.
当時の技術ではコンセプトをうまく表現できないなと思って、まあ、残念ながら諦めました。その後も再チャレンジのチャンスはあったんですが、イメージ通りのゲームにまとめられそうに
と思って、また諦めることになりました。
正直この機
会 If your vision doesn't come out the way you want it to, I would suggest waiting and, you know, prolonging it a bit.
Steam Entertainment はすごく優秀なチームだったんです。技術力は高いし、センスもいいし、まあ、なんといってもメトロイドというゲームの理解が
I guess the word I was looking for was delayed.
この最高のパートナーと組んだら、メトロイドドレッドは必ず完成すると確信しました。そして、思い描いた以上のメトロイドドレッドがこうやって完成しました。今回登場するエミーを一言で言うと、めっちゃ恐ろしい敵です。
エミーは
実は銀河連邦所有の調査ロボットなんです。特定のゾーン内をうろついてサムスが立てる物音を感知して近づいてきます。
Wow! So you're being chased the whole time?
捕まえるために高速で追いかけてきます。
That's gotta be pretty stressful.
しかも捕まるとほぼ即死。これは厳しいですね。サムスはそんな恐怖と戦いながらミッションを遂行しなければならないんですね。今回のサムスは
Oh no. It's like Resident Evil and Mr. X or Nemesis chasing you the whole time. You're just trying to do your mission.
その陰に隠れて見られないようにもできます。そして対抗手段の代表格がサムスがエミーから見えなくなるファントムクロークという光学迷彩アビリティです。これの使い方がゲームの進行を大きく作用します。歯が立たない敵に見つからないように行動するエミーのゲームパートはメトロイド体験への強烈なスパイスになっていると思います。ここまで新要素を中心に話してきましたので、全体のゲームデザインが変わっちゃったんじゃないかなと思われたかもしれません。でもそこはご安心ください。従来通りのゲーム性に磨きをかけて、アクションや探索要素の強化や工夫はバッチリです。サムスリターンズのアクションを洗練させて、フリーエイムやメレーカウンターなどを扱いやすくしました。基本アクションとしてスライディングっていうのを追加するなど、アクション面はかなりの充実ぶりですので、ゲーム体験はより快適になっています。当然メトロイドを遊んだことのない方もいらっしゃると思いますので、最後にメトロイドの探索要素について簡単に触れておきますね。メトロイドは探索型のアクションゲーム。
クラシック。
パワーアップアビリティを取得するとサムスのアクションがどんどん増える。それらのアクションでサムスの
They're keeping such classic things, and that's what makes us good.
これまでになかったパワーアップアビリティも当然追加しています。特定の壁や天井に捕まって移動できるスパイダーマグネットなどはその一例です。他にもいろいろありますのでお楽しみに。いろいろなアビリティを使う自由度の高い探索は今まで以上だと思います。よりダイナミックになった快適なアクションによる自由な探索と、自分が追われる身となって行動する恐怖という2種類の刺激が融合したメトロイドドレッドは、シリーズ経験のあるなしに関わらず楽しんでいただけます。新しいデザインのメトロイドをこの後の任天堂スリーハウスライブで
紹介します。 Sorry guys.
ダン、よろしく。
Alright, Dan, what do you got?
Thanks, Sakamoto-san. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Nintendo Treehouse Live. I am super excited about this next segment where we're going to delve into an early work-in-progress version of Metroid Dread, show some of Samus's new moves in action, and also, I think, get to a little bit of the way the game develops this suspense and tension that gives the game its title. So I'm joined by Audrey and Teresa from Nintendo Treehouse, and Teresa's going to take us into the depths of Planet
I'm CDR. So glad they're doing more for Metroid right now.
So let's take a deep dive into the very beginning of the game. So we're going to backtrack just a little bit to show Samus's free movement here.
Gosh, I want a message. Let my sister know so bad, but I need to
punish. But one of the things
I want to watch through the whole thing first.
Free aim, which for those who played Metroid Samus Returns, this is made a comeback. You can see a lot of the area around as you use it. Also has this little tracking system that when it's targeting an enemy.
Don't know if you guys heard that in the back. That's some air freshener. Sorry if it's loud.
Nate and Sakamoto-san already mentioned.
It's like a spray.
This is the first new 2D Metroid game in 19 years.
19 years?
I don't know if you did the math, but that's a lot of years. We've been waiting for this for a long time, so we're really excited to be finally showing this to everyone.
Here's another returning move from Metroid Samus Returns, which is the melee counter. One of my favorite features. And then a new one.
This is exciting, guys. It really is.
Development of
it's been so
counter.
Long. Metroid games are so cool.
I'll let that guy move a little bit back. Come back. The melee dash. I really love that because it doesn't break momentum. I can immediately do a counter and immediate damage to an enemy.
Yeah, something this game does really well is improve upon the improvements from Metroid Samus Returns. So like
something that was good about Metroid was their environments, like especially with Super Metroid. I really hope that I'm really excited to see actually how the environments are going
to
be.
Stand still and wait for enemies to attack you. You can just go get him, which really has great movement to this game.
Yeah, I love that, like, Samus moves so well, and it's just all that freedom. It's just, this is probably the smoothest I've been able to control Samus in a really long time.
Absolutely, and you've opened up the map screen here, something that Metroid fans know to love and adore.
Yeah.
The map system is just as important in this game as ever, and it really shows you the classic.
You know,
Metroid
the blinking to show that's a hidden item would be great in a lot more games.
You look at your map, you identify areas that you haven't been to yet or aren't able to access yet.
Oh, you can do markers now?
Way through, find a new ability, push your way forward, fill in the map, lather, rinse, repeat. So that's back.
Kind of like Breath of the Wild.
In my opinion.
Yeah, and this area here is blinking white because there is something here that I haven't discovered yet. So I could use markers to kind of pinpoint it just in case I don't have an ability and I have to backtrack here once I'm able to explore it.
Yeah, don't sleep on those markers. Those can be really important in this labyrinthine world.
Sure. But this looks curious.
It is really a part of the charm of Metroid, though, having this renewed sense of purpose in your backtracking paired with pushing forward.
Yeah, another thing I want to pinpoint is the amount of work the dev team put in Samus's animations. Like,
look at the depth of the environment, you guys.
Gripping the walls when she can't move or like holding onto the ledge. It's just
yeah,
so
looking
sweet.
Around.
Yeah, you'll notice little touches everywhere, so keep an eye out for them.
That seamless transition to these sort of story scenes is great.
Little moments like this when you're in helmet view for a moment really add to
helmet
the isolation
view? Wow.
And the tone of this game.
Yeah, no, this game is a sequel to Metroid Fusion, but you can see that her suit looks a little bit different than that, so that'll be a story element that people will find out what happened when they play the game. You don't want to spoil too much.
So these are the Emmy that Sakamoto-san was talking about, and none of Samus's weapons seem to do anything against
them. Oh no!
So
run.
Yep. Oh, that slide move is so cool.
It really she is like the Nemesis or yeah, Mr. X. Nope. Nothing works. Just run.
Missiles don't work either. Oh my gosh.
So, so scary. About this being called Dread.
Yeah, Dread, all right.
They're very relentless.
Oh my, okay. Oh wow, okay. Did a little reach for me there.
Can it not climb?
Oh.
I mean, I'm sure it's going to find you eventually, but that probably just gives you a little time to like step away, but it's probably going to be able to follow you.
We're going to have to find a different way to tackle that enemy.
What's that?
You know, this thing is a central unit which controls various areas of the planet. It's sort of a biomechanical computer, kind of a homage to maybe similar units in previous Metroid games. And from this unit, Samus can power up, get a temporary power up. Arm cannon, and turn it into the Omega cannon.
Nice.
Yeah, so in typical 2D Metroid fashion, we've always seen the camera like panned around here, and now with the Omega cannon ability, there's this dynamic camera that you get to see over Samus's shoulder, which is so, so cool.
Yeah, little you additions guys. Like that really flesh out the classic 2D.
They really worked hard on this. It looks
like
amazing.
It's too far from what we loved about it.
Mm-hmm. Just makes it seem really popular.
Is it still there? Oh.
Let's see if this works against our...
Oh, no, there he is.
It takes a little while.
Will it work?
So
it does.
Don't wait too long.
Okay.
It does.
I wanted to make sure I had it on the site.
I hope you enjoyed that.
I guarantee it's not the only one.
Yeah, so it was so powerful that in order to take that Emmy down, we lose the ability of the Omega Cannon.
What?
And it goes back to a regular arm cannon.
That means you're probably going to be running from it for quite a while before you get that. Before you get that cannon. Before you get to take it out, you're definitely going to be running from it a bit. For a bit of time.
Through all of these different halls, there are so many different ways to play this game. Like Teresa is amazing.
Safe? Yeah,
she's
that's a safe progress.
Missiles, but you can also just shoot your regular.
They definitely are adding a lot of new stuff, but still keeping a lot of original aspects to it, which is pretty cool.
Really, it's up to you what kind of Samus you want to be.
Yeah, and as Audrey pointed out to earlier, that you could use free aim to do more like line of sight shooting, but you could also just free aim shoot while you're moving as well.
Nice. Oh, what? Oh, to drain the water.
It's good because you need to shoot a lot of different things in this game.
So many things. I want to see a pixelated door, and now I'm filled with dread.
Yeah, this is a new entryway.
Yep, these are the entries to the various zones that the Emmy are patrolling. And once you're in there, you need to be on the lookout for those.
Artaria?
Yeah, you can hear in the background, the music is so atmospheric. It really puts you on pins and needles.
Metro games have always had good atmosphere. The music's always been great for the atmosphere.
Can't seem to climb these yet.
Not yet. Yeah, just the detail in the backgrounds of things is great. Oh, and there he is. There it is.
Now, especially during moments like this, you can really appreciate how cool it is to have an
HD. There goes another one.
2D Metroid game.
We tried that already, Sam.
No.
Not gonna
work. Run.
Just try again. Maybe we'll overcome this one.
Now run.
See that.
So luckily, this Emmy can't go through tight spaces.
It's gonna find a way. It's gonna find a way to get to you. I guarantee it. Look at it go. Look at it climb. Oh no. Not even finishing my sentence. It's already on their tail.
Okay, you gotta.
Oh my god, they're fast. It's not like with like Mr. X and Resident Evil where like he just kind of walks slowly until he kind of gets near you.
It's still trying.
It's moving so fast. Oh my goodness.
Find another way to get to me.
Yeah.
Also, I don't know if it's my heart throbbing through my hands or if the controller, but it was pretty nerve-wracking.
How beautiful, you guys.
They're terrifying species.
Yeah, T makes it seem like she's calm, cool, collected, and badass. I like to pretend that she's actually as nervous as I am when I play it, but I don't think it's true.
I do want to point out, like, also the backgrounds, like the amount of detail that the development team has put into, like, not just the enemies in the forefront, but also in the background. I don't know if you guys can tell the shimmering thing in there.
Oh, there, it's moving.
It's okay.
That doesn't bode well.
Yeah. Well, probably. Note that for the future.
Yeah, some of those details can tell the story as effectively as, you know, a voiceover or anything.
Yeah, if you want to be a bounty hunter, you have to pay attention to details.
Mm-hmm.
And watch out for gooey enemies. This is morbid. I love the detail of, like, the rib cage in the background. You just know something went down there.
Mm-hmm.
So, the thing about Metroid enemies, too, is that some of them have patterns and you can counter them, and others don't, like this one. So, I'm just gonna
just blast him.
Move him out of the way. So.
What's this?
And this room is a communication room with Adam, who happens to be Samus's ship's PC or computer. We're going to skip this part here just because we don't want to spoil any of the lore, but Dan, if you could summarize for the folks at home.
Yeah, so as Samus is exploring, she uploads data to Adam, their ship's AI, and Adam kind of gives little analysis.
This is really nice, you guys. Metroid stuff in 2021.
You where to go or anything like that. It's still up to you to kind of.
So exciting.
There's some interesting lore in there, and you know, some little hints that you can potentially use. And in that one, Adam was basically summarizing.
Gosh, so aesthetically pleasing for sci-fi folks. Like, this is gorgeous.
And,
I love it.
Also, how dangerous they are, which we've kind of seen, but hopefully we won't see too much firsthand here.
Now, so you can see T doing a great job of just shooting at the environment, looking for secrets, looking for a way forward.
Because it's not just about you got to shoot at the environment.
There's also a lot of puzzle elements here trying to find.
Like, I'm pretty sure there was times where you've had to do that, like with your morph, I think it's called, when you do the little bombs. I'm sure you've had to blow up areas to do so, but it's still pretty cool.
Heavy, intense action.
Uh-oh. So here's it's back.
Oh.
Run. Run.
That was the Emmy, as Dan had mentioned. They have kind of three modes. One is the surveillance. The other is, which is marked with blue. They're just scanning the area.
This red mode is
so
a bad
intense.
One.
I'm like playing a game of chase
so fast
with it.
My goodness. Run.
And then when it has Samus on eyesight, it turns red, which is the chase mode.
Oh, her.
Yeah. So yellow is, it's heard a noise or sensed a vibration.
Oh my gosh, she's trying so hard. Oh no.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh gosh. No.
And
no.
Oh. No. Oh my god, that's horrifying.
Are pretty relentless and ruthless.
It's so fast. It's so fast.
Like permadeath, which is very unusual for enemies with, in the Metroid series. But luckily, it's not very. It's,
sorry
the
about
game's
that.
Pretty forgiving. It allows you to respawn at an area that you were in recently.
Okay,
so
that's
able to just go
with how much it was chasing you. That's pretty forgiving. That's good.
Yes, T said insta kill is new to the series, but. It's really great because it offers a chance for you to have that challenging difficulty that I think Metroid fans expect, but without being quite so punishing with the respawning that you just have to play the whole game to get back to where you are. So it's a really wonderful balance.
Yeah.
And where is she trying to go?
The Emmy are in patrol mode, which is that...
they do come through the door.
It's in pursuit of me. They're scanning areas where they last sensed movement. Mm-hmm. And so they'll go and investigate it, and then if they see something in eyesight, then they'll go chase it.
Mm-hmm.
This is such a small but really neat touch, the way that Samus moves slower in the water.
Yeah, and the audio change too. Yeah. I absolutely love that detail.
That's pretty cool. I love little details like that. It really makes the game experience a lot better.
That one straggler there. I don't need a save. I'm feeling brave.
Oh, nice dash meleeing. See, that really shows
I wonder if you get something later that helps you actually swim rather than just run under the water.
That dash melee, you can just kind of run and gun.
The water puzzle. Yeah. Really love the animation of the water flowing from one area to the next. Such a cool detail.
I wonder because of the suit if there's any oxygen problems.
And here is a map room. So interacting with these room will grant me more visibility to the area that I'm currently in. So we sort of lightly touched on the narrative of this game, which occurs in the events post-Metroid Fusion. And so that's why Samus's look looks different. But also to point out, back to Audrey's point about, you know, the game is about exploration and action. And so this area map upgrade allowed me to see more about the map. But you can see that there's still a lot of obscurity here. And so you need to explore in order to uncover more of the area and also any secrets involved. So
yeah, it's also worth noting that this series and this game is full of really juicy lore, so whether you're a new or returning Metroid,
all right, so
if you've never played a Metroid game before, really,
I think I've watched enough. I'm going to watch the rest of my own.
And if you are a long-time
let me
Metroid fan,
bring the volume down or mute this. Okay, so I just read in the description that it's going to be 3 hours of deep dives on gameplay for the handful of Nintendo Switch games in the Nintendo Treehouse, so that's going to be a long video, so I think I'm going to end this recording here, but I'm going to continue watching the deep dive on my own time while I work. So thank you guys for watching this. I know this might have been awkward and weird because it's my first time doing something like this, but I had fun watching it. I'm a little disappointed there was no Tomodachi, but we have plenty of time for more announcements. But I'm excited about Metroid, and it's been so long. But thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed watching the Nintendo Direct. And I hope you guys also continue watching the deep dive of gameplays. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. And I hope you have a great day. Hit that like button. Subscribe if you want to. It's all up to you. But thanks, guys. Bye.